Hello, welcome to another episode of Ask Aunty. In today's episode, I'm going to answer one of the most commonly asked questions by parents, most of the time mothers of sons. Okay, so one of the common complaints that I get is mothers calling me and saying, hey, you know, we've been looking for a partner for my son for quite some time. However, nothing's really worked out. The girls that he meets seem to have a lot of demands with respect to many things. They don't want my son to live with his parents. They want him to earn above a certain salary. They want him to have a certain height. They want him to have plans 5-10 years from now. Girls seem to be really fussy and you know, somehow things are not working out. Can we do something to help my son? Firstly, let me just say that it's a great question. I would prefer to be having this conversation with your son rather than with you. However, given that you've asked me this question, there are a few things that I'd like to tell you so that you can understand why your son may be struggling. Firstly, times have changed. Women are a lot more demanding today than they were 30, 35 years ago, and for good reason. Right? They're a lot more educated, they're a lot more qualified, they're a lot more exposed to different cultures, and they understand what they want from a relationship, unlike, let's say, you did 30, 35 years ago. You may have been equally or more qualified than your husband, and you may have adjusted to your husband and in-laws and children, and you may have accommodated them in ways that you can't imagine women these days doing it. And that's fine, because people are different, and also the kind of exposure you had may be very different from the kind of exposure women these days have. People can see different relationships, and they have access to information about different relationships much more than you did today, and they know that they're capable of being in an equal partnership, unlike maybe you did back then, which means that they not only have a right for an equal relationship, they also know that they have a fairly good chance at it. So they have little reason to actually settle for somebody who does not respect their desires or wants. Second thing, your son is an adult, right? He has to make this decision independently. He should ideally not be consulting his parents to make this decision. If he's not able to make this decision independently, he's going to struggle a lot to actually survive a marriage, and he is more likely to fail in his marriage than succeed if he's not able to think independently and understand what the opposite gender wants before even getting into a relationship. And thirdly, this is demand supply, right? Whether women are demanding or not, if he wants to marry somebody of the opposite gender, he has to provide them with what they're asking for, and they have to provide him with what he's asking for. And only when there is a sort of middle ground that two parties reach, is there a possibility of a relationship, right? Your crib cannot be that the other side was too demanding. That just means that the supply could just not meet the demand. That's all it is. But having said that, let me just say that despite women being demanding or men being very docile and innocent, every person will find somebody who matches their wavelength in terms of thinking or the kind of life that they want to live, etc. And they will most likely end up with somebody. And you as parents only need to support and give them the confidence that they can do this on their own, rather than worrying with them, because that is only going to bog them down further. Because what most adults need from their parents is just support and confidence or trust that they're able to do this on their own. Nothing else. Parents may not be able to understand this or appreciate this today because you guys got a lot of hand-holding from your parents in terms of this decision, and you did not have a lot of choice in terms of making this decision. However, you are giving your children a lot of choice. But in order for them to truly appreciate this choice, they need to know that you truly trust them and trust their choice to be able to make this decision confidently. So, although this may have sounded really harsh to mothers of sons, believe me, women of this generation will appreciate mother-in-laws who root for women, and not because they want to be good mother-in-laws, because they're women themselves and they understand the kind of struggles that women go through in marriages, and appreciate that women have a voice today and they're able to exercise their choice today much more than you were able to 30, 35 years ago. And it's only then can you actually truly support your son in being able to find a strong woman just like you to be able to build a relationship with. So I hope this was helpful. In any case, leave your feedback, comments, critiques, anything that you feel like, and feel free to also leave questions that you'd like me to answer in the future. I'm happy to do that. Until then, take care.